We have another rule for exponents called the zero rule. The zero rule at first does not sound logical. It says that any base other than zero to the zero power is equal to one. That's not what most people expect, but let me see if I can convince you that it is so. What if I had the expression x to the fifth over x to the fifth? Well, if you use the quotient rule, you would say that's x to the 5 minus 5, which is x to the 0. If instead you looked at that and you just reduced it based on how you've always reduced, if you have x to the 5th over x to the 5th, anything over itself you've learned is equal to 1. So if this expression is equal to x to the 0, but it is also equal to 1, then those two must be the same. And that's just almost a proof of the fact that x to the 0 is 1. Any base to the 0 is 1. If I have 2x to the 0, that's equal to 1. If instead I have 2x to the 0 without parentheses, the 2 remains a factor. It's 2 times 1, which is 2. So, if I want the entire product to be raised to the zero power, I would have to put it in parentheses. Let's look at a few exercises. The first one says, what's the 13 to the zero power? It's 1. What is parentheses 5x to the zero power? It's 1. What is negative 8x to the zero power? Well, x to the zero power is 1, so this is negative 8 times 1, which is negative 8. This next one, I have 10 to the 0 plus y to the 0. Well, 10 to the 0 is 1. Y to the 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. And that's all the practice we're going to do with exponents of 0.